So it's July 2018. I first met Anthony Walton in April of 2014, so it's been over 4 years now. And I'll just have to say, without God's intervention in my life, through Anthony specifically, I would not be standing before you here today. Anthony was actually the one that God used to convince me to go into the Grace Community International internship program 4 years ago. And also, he was a great confidant for me when I first moved here from San Diego to the LA area about 2.5 years ago. Anthony is a great listener. He was someone that I knew I could trust, and that really meant a lot to me. As a pastor, I know he will be one who is compassionate, one who is nurturing, one who is relational. And as an elder, as a pastor, someone who can relate to a wide range of people. He has a gift of connecting with others and making them feel cared about and important. So I'm really grateful to know Anthony. I'm really glad that he affectionately calls me nicknamed Fam. That I'm like family to him. And it's an honor, it really is a privilege to be able to have this kind of friendship that I've had the privilege of having with Anthony, that I'm almost like a sister to him. It really is an honor. So Anthony, I just look forward to where God's going to take you and what God's going to do through you in the near future, in the long term,
and in the now. So,
thanks for being my friend.
Hi, brother. Hello. I brought my Moody handkerchief with me. Now, for those of you who don't know, I have a tendency to perspire sometimes. I'm never prepared. I always forget to bring anything with me. But today I did. And this handkerchief, though, is for more than just perspiration. I'll explain. This handkerchief is part of a gift that was given to me by my local pastor in Greenwood, Mississippi. And my wife will tell you that from the day he gave me this may have been 3 years ago, what on earth am I going to do with a handkerchief? Other than the little silky ones that you put in your pocket and shell. What am I going to do with a handkerchief? But, you know, I come to realize that it's a very important gift, something that is very useful to me. And I brought this with me because it reminds me of how often God blesses us in such a way that we don't realize the importance and significance of that blessing for a long period of time, if we do it all. All too often, we don't even recognize it or realize it at all. And I think that describes my relationship with Anthony. But I've known him for a very long time, at least knowing who he was, and I've only gotten to know him since he's been in L.A. And I'll tell you, when the day Mr. Kazan first brought him here, I looked at him and said, oh, trainee, what am I going to learn from him? What am I going to even do with him? He can't teach me anything, surely. But man, I'm gonna tell you how wrong I was. From the very first, this young man has been a teacher and an inspiration. Remember when we had the open house? And we went out into the neighborhood and invited our neighbors to a 10-hour function? All right, I participated, but my heart wasn't in it. I was fairly apprehensive about it. But I was in the same group with him. That young man went up, started knocking on doors, meeting and greeting and conversing with strangers, and I was amazed. I marveled at it. So I was embarrassed too. So I followed his example, and I started to do and learn to do the same thing. And so what normally would have been, and I expected to be a fairly dull and uninspired afternoon, turned out to be very exciting. Because I learned from Anthony how to relate to others. I learned how to share. Had a desire to share the gospel with others. I think I appreciate it. 3 weeks ago, we were sitting in the back, and we were just talking over various things, right? And I mentioned to Anthony about how years ago, growing up in the South, I basically, one of my responsibilities was to take my grandmother wherever she wanted to go, visit the neighbors, like friends and stuff during the day. And I never wanted to do it, but I was the youngest, so I had to do it. And a few years ago, back when Mr. May was our pastor, he called me one night and asked me if I could assist Mrs. Ravelo, for those of you who remember her, with her affairs. I'm thinking, why didn't you call me? And I was sharing that with Anthony. And I told him how I've been working with seniors ever since, and he said a very important thing. He doesn't realize it, but he did. He said, John, what an interesting way to develop a ministry. Taking it back to my childhood and my grandmother, the time I had to spend with him. I'm thinking of that. I never thought of it as a ministry, exactly the opposite. But I've always been working with seniors. And I never thought of it as being a ministry. But thanks to him, he recognized it right off and pointed it out to me. And it has been a very inspiring thing to me, because when things get difficult, when things get tough for me, when I think back on what I'm trying to do and look at it from the standpoint of a ministry, which is entirely different, is very inspirational and is very helpful. And it helps me to rededicate and it reinvigorates me. And so it helps me just be determined to see it through. And I think I owe that to Anthony, and I thank him very much for it. You know, all too often, like I said, we receive blessings and we don't really realize it when we get it, and we don't really appreciate it. That young man is a blessing to me, and I thank God that he's brought him into our midst, and he taught me how to take advantage of it.